Hello and welcome to another episode of Forza Horizon 5 Let's Go Live with Playground Games. Last time we travelled through jungles and swamps and to the top of a volcano, but today we continue our exploration of Forza Horizon 5's new biomes. But let's have a look at the schedule first. So first, we're going to be taking you for a spin through the Living Desert, Sand Desert, and Rocky Coast biomes before heading to the Mulahay town for a race. And obviously, before we say goodbye, we'll take more time to answer some of your questions. So let us know what you want to know in chat. Now, I was going to, as normal, introduce Mike and Chris here, but they seem to have completely disappeared. So instead, I'm going to shout, lads, where have you gone? What's going on?
Hey, come this way. So we know a few of you have been complaining that we haven't really shown any new cars for a while on any of the live streams. Oh, we've all seen the M Sport Fiesta before. Everyone's seen a 911. And, you know, we thought, fair point. We haven't actually shown any new cars since E3. And then we were thinking, if we're going to show a new car, we might as well do it with a little bit of flair. Go on, Chris. The 2020 Toyota Supra GR is coming to Forza Horizon 5 on day one. Chris, should we go check it out in game?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go.
Well, that makes a bit more sense now, doesn't it? Come on, gang. Come on, I can see you running through. You're only a little bit late.
Hello.
Welcome both. Are we well?
Very well, thank you. Great to be here, Charlie.
It's a good day, huh?
It is. Good. We've had fun so far.
Right, Mike, we'll come to you first. What was all that about? Tell us about the excitement that we've just seen. Was that a Supra?
It was a Supra, Charlie. So it's, as I just said, it's been a little while since we've done a car reveal, been all the way since E3, and we thought, why not do it with a little bit of theatre and get a Supra down here? And very kind of Toyota to lend us the car for the day, so we've been having some fun with that. Thought we'd reveal a new car to the world.
Kick things off with some absolute style, I think you'll agree. Now, Chris, it's worth addressing that you are taking the place of our beloved Andy today as our resident driver, but we do need to take a look at the Supra in-game, so let's dive in and crack on with that straight away.
Yeah. So, may as well have a look at it in Forza Vista. Absolutely beautiful.
There she is.
I was saying to Mike earlier when we were looking over the car, all the vents on it, so you can see just behind, next to the tail lights there, right underneath them, in the door, on the fender, they're all fake vents. Toyota put them there so that the aftermarket could put in vents for things like oil coolers and things like that. So when people start upgrading it, the vent locations were already there, which is absolutely fantastic.
So it's a car that from Toyota is built to be upgraded.
Yes.
Which
segues on beautifully, doesn't it?
Maybe we should do that now.
Should we take a look at some of the upgrades?
Yep. So we'll have a body kit or two. So we've got the fantastic Toyota Heritage kit. I really like this kit. The Toyota unveiled this at SEMA 2019. This is one of my favorite parts of it. The rear bumper changes the tail lights be like the Mark V Supra, and then the side skirts as well. And I absolutely adore this kit. I think it works really well with the lines of the car. But of course, this being Horizon, gotta have the wide body kit.
Oh, you gotta.
So no decal here. This is a dev build, but this is a HKS wide body kit, and it's lacking something on the back, I think, isn't it?
It is. It's just a little understated, almost.
I think, yeah.
There we go.
Is that wing?
There
big
we
enough?
Go.
I think that wing's big
that
enough,
might just
it?
Do.
And I think we also need some wheels to go with this as well, don't we? So let's jump in and put some wheels on it. So again, we've got a bunch of blank thumbnails here. These are all the new wheels. All the blank ones are all the new wheels coming to Forza Horizon 5. And my favorite ones are right at the bottom. Nice set of work wheels.
So blank because Chris has not yet fully set them up, but we thought we'd show you these anyway. One of the really cool things about the Supra is that this will be one of the cars that is given to every player right at the start of the game. And it'll come delivered with that Toyota Heritage kit as well in it. So everyone gets this right at the start of the game because it's an absolutely awesome car.
Nice little gift.
So let's pop that body kit on it then, shall we? And then should we take it for a drive?
I think we better.
Yeah. I think we should. And in fact, it's probably worth pointing out here, because I know I've seen this question come up loads of times in chat, but we're actually playing this on an Xbox Series X today, aren't we?
Absolutely. We are playing it on an Xbox Series X. I think there was a lot of confusion about which version of the game we were showing. So yeah, all, everything we've shown so far has been Xbox Series X. This is a development build, so there may be bugs. There may be missing thumbnails. There may well
That's
be other things
part
that we'll spot.
Of the fun, isn't
if,
it?
If they're funny, we'll call them out. Otherwise, we'll just hope that you don't spot them.
So let's get this on the road then. What is it we're going to be doing?
We're going to be exploring some new biomes, aren't we?
Ooh, yes, of course. So which one have we got first?
We're starting in the Rocky Coast. Shall we swap out Chris for Connor?
Oh, yeah, let's do it. Okay, so Chris is actually going to hop off screen now so he can drive without distraction, ergo us two. So instead of taking his face on the sofa, it's going to be Connor Cross. So Connor, if you want to come in, and Chris, if you want to go into your concentration corner. Very nice. Very good.
The smoothest of transitions.
Hello, Connor.
As if by magic, hello.
Hello. Would you like to tell us more about the Rocky Coast?
Yes, the Rocky Coast. Do we need to pan?
If we can just dip
away while we do some, we do some magic behind the scenes. Sorry, you just saw some behind the scenes magic there. So we're gonna be showing off the Rocky Coast to start with. Mm-hmm. Now that is based on Cabo San Lucas with this glorious rock arch, which I think we can go back to. It looks a lot better than me.
Just any second. There we go.
This is situated on the west coast. It is rocky and it is a coast.
There we go.
So there's lots of sea, lots of rocks. We captured this in particular on a tourist boat, funnily enough. We had photographers actually go round each of these rocks and capture hundreds of photos of photogrammetry.
If Chris looks to the left,
you can actually see some of the, that's the right.
Is that the boat? Is that it there?
Yeah, we have actually put the boat in the game.
In the game, that is comparable to the boat that we used to capture the rocky coast. So all of this, as we mentioned it a few times, but all this stuff's created with photogrammetry as well. So it's super accurate to real life, which is why it looks so amazing.
Should we take it for a spin, Chris, in your heavily modified Supra?
In its natural environment on the beach.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely. So how do you actually go about making this area for the game then? What are the fundamental elements of the Rocky Coast?
So if you want to go left here, actually, Chris, we can go past some more rocks up close. So we basically just we work out how we want to make it drivable, where we want the car to go, and what's most fun for the player to explore. Like we said, we put a lot of photographers in a boat. They took loads of photos of rocks, and then the team recreated that as realistically as
together,
possible. And then that gave us our rocky coast. It wasn't as easy as that.
Simplified it a bit.
There were some geniuses behind the scenes pulling it all together.
Some of the cool features, which are a little bit further off from the coast over there, are like hotels, golf clubs. It's like a really pristine, beautiful holiday location.
And so now we're actually heading into the sand, the sandy desert. Mm-hmm. There's big, massive sand dunes to go drive around on. It also actually connects, goes straight and dissolves into the ocean, which is really cool.
Okay.
If you go, swing a right in here, and we can actually go into some of the sand dunes.
That's stunning.
So we're actually, it's actually an autumn season, which is our stormy season. We're at a nice, foggy, atmospheric morning. And I think the lighting's quite cool because it kind of helps show off just how soft that sand is.
It does. It looks really, really fine.
You can really go in there and, deform around in it and kick up loads of sand. Probably not the best thing to do in this car, though. We'll stick on the tarmac.
Have a go, though.
As you call out the tarmac, this is an area of the world where there are just these really long, sweeping roads as well. It's the perfect place when you've got, hypercar and you just want to get up to the absolute max on the rev limiter. Mm-hmm. This is the place to go.
Now, this looks less like a sandy desert. Are we still in it? Is this another feature of a sandy desert?
Chris has gone a little bit off the agreed path here. We'll come back to that area in a moment.
We're actually going into a gypsum desert now.
Oh, I see.
It's this really fine mineral that's diamond white. I think it's carcinogenic, isn't it?
Yeah, probably best not to go there in real life. But in a video game, you're protected from any ill health effects.
All tourism to be done within Forza Horizon 5, then.
Yeah, it looks great in different times of day as well. It just picks up all that different coloured light coming through the sunlight, so you get all those beautiful reds at sunset and then blues in the morning.
This just looks like the best place to go racing. Are there any races that are actually found up around here?
Of course. Yes, there are. Yeah. There's a lot of really awesome off-road trails through here as well, like really long point-to-points. I think Chris is about to show us another cool little racing environment as well. If we hang on.
So left at that tree.
You can kind of already get a sneak peek of it on the mini-map.
If he resists the urge to jump off the edge, we can just go to the very edge and then just peek over at the Baja circuit.
Oh, look at that. Just look over the edge.
And yeah, that's
fun.
There's some really great routes around that, in and around it as well. Mm-hmm. That was also actually recreated from photos. Our team actually went and found some satellite data of, you know, recreated the roads and how they look and how the sand actually changes colour, which is really cool as well.
We'll take a closer look at that in a future stream, I think. Yeah. Now we have left the gypsum desert and very much in the living desert.
Yeah. Here we go. So what's this then? What is the living desert for those people who might not be familiar with that term?
So this is based on the Baja California desert. It's kind of contrary to what most people think of a desert, in that there is sand, but there's an absolute ton of foliage. There's all these lovely, like, you know, thick mesquite bushes everywhere. There's loads of these like yellow and cilia bushes.
Rocks.
Chris is lost.
You okay, mate?
Yeah. You're just taken aback by all the cacti. So there's lots of different cacti. We have all these weird alien-type plants called Bujum. Those things there that Chris has smashed through.
This was all planned, wasn't it, Chris?
Well, that's the execution.
Yeah. There's all these really cool little settlements as well. Mm-hmm. They've all got their own little story there as well, and they, you know, really feel like they're part of the world. Really, really true to sort of Mexican towns and things that we found in the area.
Mm-hmm. I'm remembering what you said in previous streams as well, and like that volcano is just always looming, isn't it?
Yeah. Where Chris just took a little detour, actually, there is a really nice trail that goes up there that is even funner coming down the other side.
Yeah, I bet.
there's all these like a fantastic great big rock. There's all these big rock walls here to go, you know, jump off and skirt around. But there's all these big rock structures. They're really like dominating in the environment as well, that you just suddenly come around the corner and there's this massive thing of geology. We're just about to go into another little bit of biome, which is this sort of lava, lava desert that from years ago when the volcano did its thing.
Did that volcano thing.
It did the volcano thing, yeah.
And now that lava is rocks.
And that's just like another difference to the visual of the environment. And that's full of all these big volcanic rocks that you can skirt in and around. And that's really cool.
Yeah, I think we said it already, but just the pure density of foliage here. There's just so many separate bits coming here to make this scene just feel so full of life.
And you could see them coming as well. When we went through like the sand desert and we were coming up to lizard desert.
I'm sure lizards live there.
Anyway, the living desert, you could just see it approaching because suddenly like it just got thicker with all the foliage going on. Look at that.
So this is actually, Chris, if you stop and we just sort of pan around, you can see all the detail that's gone into the roads this game.
They say no, keep going.
Hooligan driver tires.
So there's actually a seasonal river here because this is a riverbed that in autumn floods because it's the stormy season. But all that detail in the road's really cool.
Look at those cracks.
It also, when some areas where it's really sandy, those cracks actually fill up with sand, which is a nice touch. So yeah, photo mode's going to be give a lot of options for the photographers out there to get some cool environments. There is a sand road around here that will show off some of the cool new VFX that the team have done. We've really focused on tire smoke and making sure that all of the dust kick up feels really full and voluminous. It feels like it's lit from loads of, it is lit from loads of different angles now. It's a big entity in the world.
Such a cool detail.
And for the drifters out there, when you're on tarmac, the tire, I mean, Chris helped implement the system. The tire smoke is related to heat. Based on how hot the tire would be, it kicks off that amount of smoke. Just to add another layer of realism in there.
I think Chris going first person now, responding to some requests from chat.
Yeah. Oh, look at it.
Yeah, and of course that tire heat as well is affected by seasons.
Exactly.
So in the hotter seasons, your tires heat up faster, you get more drift kick up. Yeah. Um,
And in a car like this as well, it's just perfect for it.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Awesome.
Well, that was amazing. And those are the biomes we're going to talk about today. But you do have another race to show us like you did last time. You're spoiling us. So what is it we're going to be going and looking at now?
Yeah, so we just dip the feed so Chris can do a little bit little bit of magic. We're going to travel to the beautiful Mexican town of Mulegé, which is based on a real location. And we're going to take part in the Mulegé Town Scramble, which is a scramble, a dirt circuit that weaves through the town of Mulegé. And it's a really fun, really tight little circuit. Loads of height changes. Let's take a look, I guess.
Jump in.
Let's do it. Have we got money that Chris is going to do this better than Andy?
Andy did do it blindfolded.
Well, there you go. The bar is set.
Chris points to the fact there are things obscuring it.
Chris has got a camera in front of him.
But only we know that, so no one else does. So you need to prove it to everyone in chat now.
So 2 weeks ago, we looked at the Emerald Circuit, which was an asphalt route, and it was part of the Apex, Horizon Apex Festival. We can see there as we go under the race gantry, this is part of the Horizon Wilds Festival, which is a festival that's dedicated to dirt racing, off-road racing, all that like really loose surface racing.
Like fun
which is,
stuff.
Yeah, exactly. It's so much fun when you're in an awesome rally car like the Evo here.
Mulegé is in a part of the living desert that's it's really hilly.
I was going to ask where this is based and what we're looking at.
So it's actually it's like the southern part of the Living Desert. So the terrain gets more hilly, it's less rocky, and there's actually a big river that connects to the ocean. So there's like a massive oasis at the bottom of it, I guess you'd call it that, which is just full of palm trees. And that blends out into that jungle vista you can see there. I think we've got some broken checkpoints there, haven't we? You've gone through one, Chris.
So, Chris, currently in sixth place. I feel like Andy would have done better than this by now. So
I think he would have finished it by now, actually. Both laps.
Mulegé is this it's really colourful, little quaint town. I think we've even hidden a mural in there somewhere.
Okay.
People that want to go find those. One of the things we really wanted to try and maintain that we saw from the reference was all these cables that kind of hung across the road with all this lovely bunting. So we've gone some good technical lengths with the technical wizards at Pligy to make sure that we can get that to work.
Yeah, it's a town that you spend a little bit of time here in the early part of the game. It just has so much charm and character. It just feels like real Mexico. Yeah. Like I don't think it's not necessarily. It is a beautiful place. You could go on holiday there. This is like, I think, what Mexicans would think of as like the kind of places.
Okay,
they would
authentic.
Grow up in. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Every single house has got its own little charm. It's slightly different.
I remember you saying in a previous stream that obviously all the houses are all really colourful because they're intended to be as such. I just think that's such a lovely touch.
There's this amazing orange one here. Uh-huh. It's like a pink one, like just opposite it. That's it's just really pretty.
Yeah, the pink one opposite that the player may get the opportunity to. To live in at some point. Yeah,
that could be one of your homes.
Oh.
Well, we didn't show it, so I guess that remains a mystery for a future show. So, Chris keeps hitting those broken checkpoints.
Broken checkpoints, Chris.
It's a bit worried. Stop focusing on the stream and just focus on this now.
He's willingly shown a broken bit of the game just to get into first place. Commendable.
That will be remembered.
I know it will also be fixed as well. That is a bug that is already fixed in a newer build than this. Yeah. All right, so he's only got one corner left. I think he's got enough of a lead now that we can call it done. So well done, Chris.
Well done. You can come back another week, Chris. Great work. Very well done. Very good. That was stunning. I love that you're showing us all these different races, and it's not too long until we get to do them ourselves. But I think chat have some questions they would like you to answer now, if that's okay.
Are you braced?
Are we ready?
Let's go.
Let's do it. Okay. So the first question comes from Xbox Berg, and it says, will there be a moving train around the map? I suppose we did see that in 4, so are we bringing it back?
It was such a fun part of Horizon 4 that I don't think we could really do a map without one now. They are just they add so much dynamism to the world.
It lives in the canyon.
Okay.
And I think it's one of the cool, it's the coolest train we've done, isn't it?
It
because
is.
You can weave in and around the train tracks and it goes across over the road. I think we saw it
in the E3 demo.
There was, okay.
We got a sneak peek of it, only on screen for a couple of seconds.
Oh, maybe but, I need to go find it again. I don't remember a train. I need to go hunting for that
Plus
now.
Plus it's in the canyon with all that like ray traced audio that Fraser was talking about, so it sounds really cool.
Lovely. Okay, great question. The next one comes from Gaming Adler HD, who asks, how many festivals are in the game?
So there are
six.
Six. Sorry,
yeah, I was trying to quickly count them in my head then. But
very good. It's wild. Okay. Next question comes from the real Skeb, who says, is there normal commercial cars following street laws? In brackets, is there civilian traffic still? The one that we saw earlier clearly was not. Yeah.
So that was not civilian traffic. That was a Drivatar based on one of the dev team, probably. So that, as you know, Drivatars pick up the skills of the player which they belong to. So someone there is obviously like to go around, smash into people. But regular civ traffic is absolutely still part of the game, yes.
Lovely. Okay, the next one comes from Craconius, who asks, are we getting a physical performance impacting damage in Forza Horizon 5, or will it remain purely cosmetic?
So the functionality there is similar to Forza Horizon 4. So there is a setting within the assists where you can turn on sim damage if you want to.
Okay.
It might not give you the great experience, because a lot of the gameplay you do, such as danger signs and things like that, might damage your car.
Whipping it around, you might not want to trash
it. It makes it very, very difficult. Yeah. But it is an option if you're looking for that authentic experience. Yep.
Lovely. Okay. And the last question comes from Alex Kawina, though I have a feeling almost every single person in chat has asked this at some point. They're asking, full map reveal when?
When? Because we did make a promise, didn't we?
We did.
We should show it now.
Let's have a look now.
Right, go on, Chris. Right, so Chris, back behind the wheel, but this time driving on the map.
Should we go back and show just where we've driven on the map?
So we can see the scramble there that we've just done, right? That was Mulahay. Yeah. That's a scramble.
There's the El Arco in Cabo, and then going up, we've got the sand dunes, and then a bit of that gypsum desert, and there's the Baja circuit.
That's what we peeped at earlier from over the hill, right?
We did. So people can now get a good look at that and start to work out how they're going to build their own routes through there using Event Lab.
And then if you go right, you can just see how massive that volcano is.
It's a big volcano.
So on the right there, that massive stretch of road is the asphalt switchbacks we showed last time, and the other massive switchback is the dirt one as well. So you can go up either of those ways or cross country, and there's probably about 100 different ways you can jump off of it as well.
Yeah,
perfect.
And then here we are in Guanajuato. That's that amazing city, which has also got the canal, the tunnel. Yeah, tunnel. Mm-hmm. I was stuck on tunnel. The tunnel system underneath, so you can drive through there and then come out of this beautiful city. And then just north of here, there is
It's the canyon.
It's
we were
canyon.
Just talking about this with the train. Yeah. So I don't think you can make out the train track on the map there, but the train basically runs full length of the canyon, doesn't it?
Yeah.
There's another awesome drift road there as well that takes you down into the canyon.
The canyon is, I think it's 2/3 of the length of the map as well.
So wow, okay.
Yeah. Massive.
It's a great road.
It's fairly significant then, huh?
Now we're looking at the tropical coast on the east of the map, and down there is the town of Playa Azul. This is what we showed with that beautiful mural art by Farid Rader. Mm-hmm. So that there's actually two of his murals in that town for the mural hunters.
Mm-hmm. tell them everyone.
So we will get a closer look at this biome in a future stream. But whereas the rocky coast we saw earlier is really dusty and dry and rocky, this is super lush and green and tropical.
Mm-hmm. It's worth saying as well, we are going to let's put up a high resolution one of these if we haven't already. So don't worry about stitching this thing together. We'll give you the proper one.
Yeah, check
so
out.
You can zoom in yourselves.
Check
and
it out.
Figure it out.
Yeah, it'll be on our Twitter and Insta within the next few minutes. I'm reliably insured. So,
perfect.
No need to be screen capping this. There will be one out that you can just digest at your heart's content.
So, are there any other like particular features you want to call out, or any favourite areas?
If you head slightly north, Chris, I think it's worth calling out the stadium. So we showed this during our E3 presentation. It's where we had that Event Lab creation with all the bowling pins and the jumps and stuff. It's a really big open space. It's the perfect place to get in there and build using our amazing UGC tools.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I know you've mentioned previously, but the map's bigger than Forza Horizon 4. Like, to what scale, or how does that actually translate?
It's 50% bigger.
Okay.
So 1.5 times the size of Forza Horizon 4.
Yep. Gorgeous. Yeah. And this is the highway you've mentioned as well, right?
Yes.
The longest one so far?
There we go. For more or less the bottom corner up to the top corner, the longest we've had in any of the Horizon titles.
And yes, there is a danger sign at the end.
Just absolutely yeet yourself off the end of it. Love it.
Yeah, straight out.
So your favourite is the stadium. Or did you have another favourite, Mike?
My favourite area actually is the main festival, which is just where Chris is highlighting right now. You can actually see that it's built around an old abandoned racetrack, so there's a really awesome race circuit through there, which I think it will become the natural test track for people when they're building out their tunes, and I think we'll probably use it to test out some vehicles in a future stream. It's also got that runway running right the way through it, which acts as a drag strip. And in the centre of the festival, that main bit there, where you can just see that runway intersecting. Mm-hmm. This is amazing artwork that's painted down onto the floor as well. It's like a really beautiful area to go and explore.
Gorgeous. About you, Connor, what's your favourite?
I've got so many, obviously.
Well, go through them all then, obviously.
let's talk about the whole map. Chris, if you tell you what, let's look at the jungle. So what we showed off...
Yeah, tell you what, I've just been reliably informed that the image is now on Twitter.
It is, okay.
So if you want to go find these areas at the same time we're talking, that could be a fun little, like, a bit to do. Anyway, you were saying... I'll try to think of a really clever word and it escaped me, so I just said bit.
I think the jungle is one of my favourite areas. And in the middle of the jungle is actually this like vast water network of waterfalls. Mm-hmm. And in the heart of that is this great big waterfall called Agua Azul, which I haven't stopped going on about, as Mike assured me, since the beginning of the project. Because it's so stunning. It's amazing work of art by our team who've been working, you know, tirelessly to get over this technical challenge. Mm-hmm. And not only that, but it's amazing because you can jump off of it, you can drive around it. It looks good at all times.
Is this the one that we saw in the trailer?
It is the same one. Yeah. There it is on the map there. You can see just how big that thing is. Yeah. So it covers most of the jungle.
He's not joking either. He started talking about 3 minutes after we chose Mexico as the location. There's this
We've
waterfall.
Got to do it.
It's called the Agua Azul waterfall.
Before we talk about cars or anything else, there's this waterfall that has to be in here.
It's great. It's a great waterfall. People have already spotted all the temple sites, I guess. But we've got Teotihuacan there, Tulum on the east coast. We've got Ekbalam. There's the Giants of Tula, and there's Uxmal as well. So, yeah, I think temple sites, I mean, they're inherently cool. So they probably are my favourite.
Love seeing those the other week. That was brilliant. Well, lovely. I think that's everything of the map that we're going to go through today. And that's everything we have time for today. So thanks to all of you in chat, as always, for being mega inquisitive, as always. And thank you, Mike, Connor and Chris. Stand there. Well done, Chris, for guiding us through Mexico today. We'll have more cars to show you on the next Let's Go stream later this month as we continue to tick down the days until Forza Horizon 5's launch on November 9th. Keep up with all the latest Forza Horizon 5 news and updates by following Forza Horizon social channels. Thanks again for tuning in today. We will see you next time. Adios. Bye.
Day one with Xbox Game Pass.